There was a scan that went down right here, which spotted that base, and he should be moving up with a couple siege tanks. These siege tanks should be able to take out these cannons pretty effectively. And as you can see, Vonstroke's units are all up here, so there's going to be no defending that, unless he warps in some stalkers or sentries to just block off the ramp. But nothing going on at this time. I'm not sure if he's going to be responding to that. He does have one Colossus. I believe he should be getting the Colossus range right now. Doesn't have charge or anything. This charge and blink are extremely effective against Protoss versus Terran. Especially blink. Because once you get a big stalker army and you just blink into your opponent or just blink harass like on this ridge here, it's really effective. Especially if you can go in, just snipe a few buildings, run out. Very effective. And this base is still saturated pretty decently, but Tony the Terran player, is actually fully saturated at his third base with a factory right there, and a sensor tower for better, you know, observation. Sensor towers are extremely good. If you're going high mech play, not as many people recommend this. Not as many people actually recommend getting sensor towers because they're not really worth the cost. But later on in the game, if you look at the resource tab, they both have a lot of money right now. You can really just plot down a couple sensor towers like wherever you want. And especially if you're going high mech play as a Terran player, sensor towers really help as you're able to prematurely see like anywhere on the map, and you can just go in that direction once you see the red dots coming towards you. And looks like he actually backed off from attacking this, as this sensor tower probably saw this army coming in, so he backed off all his units. We do have a couple points defense drones here down a little early, probably before this army even got there. A couple of High Templars being warped in right now, although they do not have the Kaidaran Amulet or Storm researched yet, and we actually have, what do you call, depleted, they don't even say depleted, they just say remaining zero, while StarCraft 1 was more advanced in that regard. Not sure what's shining there, what is that? Does that just mean it's depleted? Anyway, on this position we have the Terran player moving out with quite a few siege tanks at this time, 11 siege tanks. And the Protoss player does have these Colossus. I would really recommend probably getting more Colossus at this point, because he did get the range, so they're definitely upgraded. He really didn't get any upgrades. He only has plus one weapon upgrades, which is really going to kind of cut into the effectiveness of his troops. Although the Terran player also only has 1-1 for his bio army, and no upgrades for his tanks. But I don't think he really needs it at this point. That's a lot of siege tanks. That amount of siege tanks will pretty much destroy all those gateway units. And we actually have a Hellion drop going down. No pre-igniter at this time. Hellion drops being very effective. That dropship actually being taken out. And those Hellions mostly only killed like 4 or 5 probes at the most. I assume a bunch of cannons up as defense over here. And looks like we're playing 3 base to 2 base now. So we'll see who spends their resources more effectively. As you can see, the Protoss player has a shit ton of money right now. He is almost supply capped. So they're both reaching about 200 armies, kind of turtling in before they push out. If you're not moving with your siege tank army, you should really siege the tanks before moving them, or like just like not moving them at all, just siege them up. Really good spot to siege is right there, like the Tony has done, although these couple bio units are getting stuck. As this area, if you siege a tank here, the Zeldaga Tower pretty much gives automatic vision, so you don't even need like Vikings to scout for that specific spot. And it's really easy to hold Zeldaga Tower, to be honest, as there's a lot of cliff ridges here and siege tanks do pretty much full damage anyway, as there is no reduced damage anymore from siege tank or low to high ground fire. Nothing going on at this moment, just a couple more Colossus, both of them getting supply capped. I believe they are about even on army cap. It's pretty surprising how even they are at this point. But quite a few Templar, that is literally 10, 13 Templar, 13 the unlucky number, although he does have Psionic Storm as well as feedback, so he gets beast potentially seeing some feedback on these medevacs and ravens to take them out really quickly. Particularly that raven. If you can do that, that's pretty good. Although you'll probably likely see a premature point defense drone pretty soon. Maybe, maybe not, who knows. And both of their armies just kind of scouring the map, looking for openings, just kind of going through. You should really attack at this point. If you're a Protoss player and you're max capped at this point and you don't really want to push, what I would recommend is plot down a ton of extra gateways and then switch them into warp gates. Once you got about 15 warp gates, you can really push out at any time. Because if you lose that army, you can pump out your army again, at least your gateway units, extremely quickly. Within 2 minutes, you'll have your whole army once again. Less than 2 minutes, maybe. You can do Chrono Boost on the warp gates, and boom, you have so many units back. And maybe like one or two robotic facilities for the Colossus. These High Templar aren't gonna be, they're really prime targets for all these units. As a couple siege tank fires on that High Templar line is gonna be extremely effective. If you're a Terran player and you ever see High Templars like that, try and get a siege tank shot into that big ball of High Templar, and it'll be extremely effective. But otherwise, siege tanks have like really smart shooting now, so they pretty much shoot really well. A lot of ice storms in the wrong spot, although he's kind of protecting his army from moving out. A bunch of more size storms, pretty effective. As you can see, a lot of these units getting softened up, but there's way too many siege tanks for this Protoss player to deal with. And should be able to actually finish off these units, but once they move into the siege tank line, they just get demolished. One Immortal, one Stalker, one High Templar, suitably, just survive and constantly sniping, making a little bit of a harass. Lots of Vikings and siege tanks. Pretty decent army composition. Vikings being extremely good against air, as well as siege tanks being extremely good against ground. But if you're faced with this army, I'd probably recommend getting, like, more Immortals, maybe some more, like, just better well-placed storms. Because you really need to surround these tanks, get micro, catch them off guard. That's what you really want to do. If you can catch them off guard, that's really effective. Just a couple, like, High Templars to spawn right here. Just storm all over this front, softening them up. Because he has no SCVs repairing, although he has one following. But auto repair is not on. If you're a Terran player, you want to, and you're going mech, you should have like some SCVs just on auto repair the whole time. It's pretty effective. Especially when you're not doing anything, you're just macroing up. And looks like we have these siege tanks just kind of inching in towards the Protoss line. A bunch of more robotics facilities going down, but those robotics won't do anything at this point. Fairly small army. The reason why this army is so small and Vonstroke's resources, oh my god, it's like he typed show me the money. He only has 5 warp gates, and looks like he GG's, or doesn't GG and just leaves the game, but that was a good game, I guess. Although, Protoss player could have definitely put down more gateways. If he had done that, he would have been way better off reinforcing his base right now. Anyway, stay tuned for more games, and peace out.